If you have peace on the day of Qiyamah, you have peace forever. That is the peace that is required. But if you have pieces on that day, wallahi, then subhanallah, we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not make us from amongst those who will regret on that day. Remember, it is not too late to prepare for the day. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with signs of Qiyamah. There is a famous hadith known as Hadith Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam. I'm sure we've heard it. Where Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam came and he sat with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with utmost respect and he began to ask him questions. And mal islamu, mal imanu, mal ihsanu, etc., etc., until he got to Qiyamah. The response was, mal mas'ulu anha bi'a'lama min as-sa'il. When is Qiyamah was the question. The answer was, the one who is being questioned does not know any more than the one who is questioning in this regard. It is only known by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he was asked, what are the signs of Qiyamah? And an answer was given. We all know there are many signs of Qiyamah. Let me mention some of them. Zina will increase. Has that not come? Has zina decreased or increased? Tell me. It has increased, subhanallah. That is a sign of Qiyamah already predicted by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Evil will increase. People will begin to compete in masajid. Yatabaha an-nasu fil masajid. What does that mean? That means, oh, that's my masjid. Oh, that's my masjid. That's our masjid. That's their masjid. It's happening already. We are jama'at al-muslimin. We are together. We are one. We cannot say my masjid and your masjid. Masjid of Allah, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the one who contributed towards building it, wallahi, he cannot say it is my masjid. The minute he says that, he's heading in the wrong direction. May Allah guide us all. يَتَبَاهَا النَّاسُ فِي الْمَسَاجِدِ People will compete when it comes to masjid. Oh, our masjid has this. Oh, ours has aircon. Oh, yours has a carpet which is 2 inches thick. Ours only has 1 inch thick. Or mine is going to have 5 inches more. That is not what we are meant to be doing, subhanallah. You want to build the best masjid, build it for the sake of Allah. Not because the masjid down the road is any lesser than that. It does not necessarily mean that the better the masjid, the more acceptable your ibadah is. Nowhere did that happen at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, nor was it ever said in that manner. But we must understand that if we become materialistic, even regarding our deen, we are heading in the wrong direction. We become a statistic of Qiyamah. A sign of Qiyamah. We don't want to be walking signs of Qiyamah. Let me give you some more signs of Qiyamah. There were certain signs, subhanallah, that were mentioned at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Sahaba used to ask themselves, have you understood what is meant by this? And some of them did not really comprehend because the times were not there. We have seen those signs today. Let me give you one of those. أَنْتَلِدَ الْأَمَةُ رَبَّتَهَا A woman will give birth to her boss, subhanallah. So people might interpret it saying, you know, nowadays the women are giving birth, the children are becoming bosses. The children are ruling their women. That is one explanation. But let me tell you what is happening in the Western world, wallah. Women who do not want the beautiful stretch marks on their stomachs. Wallahi, having a stretch mark on a belly for a woman is a sign of jihad. It is a sign that she has been through what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants her to go through. It is nothing to say that, oh, now my belly is ugly. A'udhu billah. May Allah save us from that attitude. Wallahi, if a woman has not had those marks on her belly, she may not have contributed towards the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he says, تَزَوَّجُوا الْوَدُودَ الْوَلُودَ فَإِنِّي مُكَاثِرٌ بِكُمُ الْأُمَمَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Marry those women who are loving, who want to have children. I want to be, through your effort, the Nabi who has the greatest number of ummatis on the day of Qiyamah, the greatest number of followers. How is that going to happen if we don't want stretch marks on our bellies? May Allah grant that to us. May He grant us children. May He grant our women folk good health. So what are the women of the West doing? They take the embryo, husband and wife, they make the egg and the sperms meet in a third party. They go to the Philippines or they go to Indonesia where there are poor people who need something, a little bit of money. And they say, look, we want to We want to use your womb for 9 months. To do what? For the gestation period of our child, and we will pay you for that. And what are these women doing? Out of desperation, they are renting out their wombs. Wallahi, I am telling you what is going on around us in the world. And then what happens 9 months later? They get their payment. Have they not given birth to anything but their bosses? Subhanallah. They have given birth to a child who is not related to them. They have given birth to a child who has paid them, or whose parents, whose biological parents, have actually paid them. Is that not a sign of Qiyamah? Tempering with the signs of Allah, with the creation of Allah. وَلَآمُرَنَّهُمْ فَلَيُغَيِّرُنَّ خَلْقَ اللَّهِ. Shaitan is quoted to be saying, I will command them so that they will change the creation of Allah and tamper in it. That is a sign of Qiyamah. But wallahi, there are other signs of Qiyamah which have also been mentioned, which are regarded as grave, dangerous, extremely major signs of Qiyamah. Wallahi, if I tell you, the hadith says there will come a time when everyone will eat interest. If they don't eat interest, at least the smell of it will come to their noses. Have we not got to that time today? We don't eat it. We believe it's haram. We believe everything against it. Most of us, alhamdulillah, may Allah make us strong. But the scent of it has come to our noses, whether we like it or not. It's a sign of Qiyamah. It was predicted, prophesied by Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom we are followers of. Are we not fortunate to have been given the warning already? Let me give you another sign, dangerous sign. Dajjal will appear. Now someone might ask and say, no, when is Dajjal coming? A few minutes ago, I happened to listen to the khutbah in Makkah al-Mukarramah in front of the Kaaba. The Imam spoke on the same topic. That is where I was inspired what to speak on today. The signs of Qiyamah. I am happy to tell you that today this topic has been discussed in Makkah al-Mukarramah just an hour ago. In front of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Dajjal was discussed. Let me tell you who is Dajjal. Al-A'war, the one-eyed devil who is going to come, he will have control. Remember, I am telling you something, but I want you to use your minds to think of our situation today. We are in a Dajjal-like situation, though Dajjal himself is not in our midst, but his entire system has already fallen into place. He is preparing us and our children for the day he comes, wallah. Shaitan is doing that on his behalf. Let me tell you, Dajjal will come. He will have power. He will have money. He will have wealth. He will have food. He will have drink. The crops will be in his hands. The land will be in his hands. Economies will be in his hands. The entire dunya will be seemingly controlled by him. Seemingly, I say, because true control is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what will happen? People will be dying of hunger. They will be dying of thirst. They will be landless. They will have a lot of difficulty in terms of the dunya. And Dajjal will appear and he will say, follow me and I will give you. What will I give you? I will give you food. I will give you drink. I will give you property. I will give you wealth. I will give you the whole dunya. Follow me and I will take you to where you want. Don't you want this dunya?